Welcome back. This is the object-oriented PHP crash course, part 3. I am Fabio, and as you see, it's been a few days from the previous video, and I have shaved. Outside it's 3 degrees in the Great Britain, and it's the best weather to stay at home and study. So if you follow along, this is what we are going to build. During the part 3, I made some changes to the project. We have 3 pages, the about, the contact me, which is the page where you can find my contact details, and the about page with the video and a short description of the video. And this is where we have products that we are going to build using our objects and the classes that we defined in the previous video. So we have 6 products in the website categories and another 6 in the bicycle category. We can now click on a product, see the product title, description, its price, and we have this previous and next button, so we can use them to move forward and backwards and see all the products. And that's pretty much it. These products, small projects that we are going to build, and let's start by opening Visual Studio Code. And this is how we left our project in the previous video, part 2. If you didn't watch it, please stop this video and go back and watch the part 2 and part 1 if you didn't. And what we are going to do now is to start building some creating some products using our classes. And let's start by defining websites products for our website. So I am going to create a variable and assign to it an empty array where that I'm going to populate with some objects. So I am going to instantiate a new object using the product class that we created last time. So this is the class that we are going to use. Okay, I am going to instantiate the products. So product class, and as you see, we have Visual Studio Code that tells us that we need to put some parameters inside there. We need to specify the name of the product, so let's call it first one page website, and then we need to, let's see, a description. I am going to use a little quick snippet that I have. And I am going to put inside some lorem ipsum text, and then we need a price, so let's say 2500, and I'm not going to put the color, and let's copy this and create a few more products. So what we are going to have at the end is an array with a list of products. I'll show you what it looks like in a minute. So let's change the title, let's say 2, oops, let's say 3, 4, 5, and 6. What I'm going to do now is to render onto the page all these products. Let's put some commas at the end and not a semicolon, but we need the commas because this is an array of products objects. No comma at the end. Okay, we have 6 products and we save them inside this website variable that we can use later on to set a an image and other properties for our products. So as we see, this is the main page, the index page, where the home page, where we showcase these products, and each product has is a card and have is a title, an image, the description, this little nice button with a link to the product page, and this footer at the bottom of the card with the price. So let's go inside the index view and let's create a basic HTML page. So we have a view, we load the view, and now we need to put something inside this view because at the moment the view is empty. I am going to use Bootstrap, and I have a quick snippet. If you don't know what Bootstrap is, I suggest that you look on Google. And Bootstrap is a front-end component library that we can use to speed up our development, and you can download Bootstrap and put inside your install inside your project using npm, a package manager of Node.js, or you can use the CDN, which is what we are going to do today. We are going to use the CDN link, and so we have compiled assets, CSS and JavaScript assets, so we can quickly create page that will look nice and will be mobile friendly. And that's what we look like. And let's go back inside our page, and let's say I have a quick snippet, so I can say BS, probably BS before, yeah, before I have this quick snippet. So let's create the page. Let's put the title, PHP OOP Crash Course, and this is the products page, our home page. Okay, as you see, we have the Bootstrap CSS here, CDN, and at the bottom of the page we have some scripts that we might not need, but I'm going to leave that. And what now? Let's see what our page looks like when we load, when we boot up our PHP server. Let's put an h1 tag and say home page. Okay, let's go inside our terminal and let's start the web server that PHP has built in. So we can simply do php minus capital S, and then we can say local host. I'm going to put that to pay into support 8888, and then let's look inside our browser what we got. And this is the first page that we will where we will show all the products that we are going to output to the browser. Okay, so we have basic structure of a page, and now let's output some of the contents that we have here from this object. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is simply I will loop through the this array and then grab the product title, product description, and product price for now, because we don't have anything else for now. But we will add a new method to our class. So let's open the product class actually, because we will need it in a minute. We will put inside the product class another method so we can set an image for our product. And let's loop through the page, through the array. So let's open the PHP tag, Let's close it, and then let's say first we are going to check if we have products. So we have websites, because this is how we called this array. So we websites. Okay, let's first check if we have websites, then let's loop through it using the for each. Okay, so for each website has let's say key and item, there's a product, so an item, and here we are going to output some of the properties as we have done before. So if you want to get the title, you can either use the get title if you got one. So yeah, we can use the get name if the title is protected, but all the properties are public for now. We'll leave them as they are. So we can say, for instance, web item. So on the item name, and if we check back our page, we should see nothing because we didn't echo out the content. So let's say echo, and then we should see nothing again. Let's start by var dump this. Let's see what we got. The same page. That should output something. Why is that? So we have websites. We check if we have websites. Let's check if we have websites. Did I save the page? I think so. Nope. Okay. Let's see inside the terminal. We have a warning. Invalid argument supplied inside the for each. Yes, because it's for each website. So, and that's now, sorry, stupid mistake. Here we go. We have all our six objects that we defined previously, and let's see them a bit better. Let's grab only the names and see what they look like. Yeah, okay, we have all the products names. Now what we're gonna do is first let's give some style to our page. So what we need to do first is let's look the final application. We have a navigation bar, we have a this section with the name of the course, and then we have this navigation here. Let's start by the top to the from the top to the bottom, and let's recreate all that. So we need a navigation. Let's say just if I go to the center, home, about, and contact. I am not going to assign a link to these pages for now. I'm just recreating the basic structure. Let's look the front end, and yes, we have these. So let's give it some padding, and what else? We should give them padding and a shadow. So I will use some of the utilities classes of Bootstrap to recreate that. So first I am going to say, let's think about padding on the axis Y, and let's say 4, and then let's give it a shadow and a fixed top and the background of white. If you don't know what I'm doing, because I'm using the Bootstrap CSS classes that are available thanks to the front-end, this front-end component, and they are predefined classes that we can use out of the box. And this one set the navigation bar at the top of the page, and that will keep scrolling with the rest of the with us. I mean, we'll be stick at the top. And then we have a background of white color, the shadow, and the padding top and padding bottom set to 4, which should be like 20 pixels probably. Let's see what it looks like. Okay, we are getting there. So we have this section here, which is a Jumbotron. This is how it's called. So let's remove that, and let's put a some an header. Yeah. Okay, and inside here I am going to put a Jumbotron. Let's do that. Jumbotron default. I will change that to weather, and then I will simply remove all that stuff, put my H1 tag. I am not going to remove the container. Wait a second. Okay. I'll place a container first, and then my anchor tag, and I will place this to the center. And padding on the Y axis to 4, 5, and let's see how it looks like. Okay. We need now to add some classes to our Jumbotron. So let's say that we want this Jumbotron to be fluid, and then a background of dark and the text of white, and the margin top, let's say 5, which is should be 3.5 rem, and that's it. Probably we could put the padding on the x-axis of 4. Let's see how it look like. Okay, that's fine. Now what else? Okay, we need this tab and its cards. There should be a snippet for that as well. So let's say that we want before tabs and that's appeals. Another one. Let's grab it from, I don't know, it seems I don't have a snippet for that. Okay, let's grab it from the Bootstrap website. That's what you're going to do probably if you don't have a snippet set on your yeah, it's the documentation. Let's grab the documentation and let's search for a nav tab. Tabs probably should be this one. Yes, I want to grab which one? A simple one, probably this one. Yes. Let's copy that and let's go back inside our code, and in the index page let's move that to the bottom. So we have nav tabs. Put a comment here so we remember what it is. Nav tabs, and this is the nav panes. Tab panes, and then let's see what it looks like now. Let's put some content here. We need only two, so we can remove one and place our content here, and then we will use also this one. So here we will put the bicycles. So let's rename this. That's not going to be profile, but that's going to be bicycles. So we can change all these occurrences and say no one just the profile to bicycles. And then the home will be products. The final one we can move that we don't need. And what else? Okay, products with capital letter and bicycles with capital letter. And let's place our loop here for now. Let's move it in here. Okay, let's check what it looks like now. Okay, we have this tab and this is empty and this is fine. Okay, we should put that in to the center and add these products before it. So let's do that now. So before this, I am going to say em, which is empty, class of class of display flex, and I will align the items to the center and padding right of 5 and say that products. Then I am also going to put these pills to the center. So display flex, I'm using flexbox, the bootstrap is this, to align the contents to the center. And also a margin bottom, crease bottom to 5. Looks better. Okay. So we have products, we have bicycles. Okay. Let's put a column here. Now, what I want to do is wrap the loop inside the container. Okay, so I will say first that I want a div with an ID of products, and inside here I will place a row. And in here I can look through these products, and then instead of var dump just the name, I am going to include a card to display each product individually like that. So this is a card, should have a quick snippet for that so I don't have to write much code. So first, okay, first let's close the PHP tag and let's reopen it here so we can put HTML code here. And let's say before card I want a default card, let's see, I don't need the image card, yeah, I need the image, let's use the default card. Let's wrap the card in a column first. So we have a grid, column of 4 for now. And let's put that. So every time we loop through the array, we repeat the column with a card element inside it, and that will display our card. Let's give to this card, I will use different elements in a second. So okay, we have a card here. Okay, we need to put a container, I think, somewhere. Yeah, I didn't put the container over there. So class, we need a container. So all the cards will be nicely centered to the page. I want to use some semantic HTML5 code here to display the card, so I am going to replace this div element with an article. I should replace its counterpart article. Okay, and I will add some shadow to the card and around the borders quite a lot, and put some margin on the axis Y, and you can check what this does by looking at the page and expected page. And it's safe, yes. So now the card should look much better. If you want to check what it does, you can open the Google Inspector and you can see, for instance, this class, this card body, has a flex of 1, 1, which is a flex grow 1, flex shrink. Okay, you can open the property and check what's inside. The padding is set to 1.25 RAM for all these elements, and we can change that. As you see, there is not much contrast. It tells you that the contrast is not high enough for the accessibility, so it's 3.98, and there is an exclamation point which says you should increase that. We do that in a minute when we put these to dark. Okay, for now we have all these cards. We didn't set the borders. Okay, let's check what we need to build. Okay, we need this title to the head, the image, the description, the product button, and this price. Let's start by the header. Okay, we first need an header, so in here I will put the an h3 element, and I will give it a class of card title. This should be the default class for the title of a card, and then in here I will use the PHP tags and echo out the title of the item, or sorry, the name. Since this is a public property, I can access it from outside the class using the just its property name. Otherwise, if that was protected, as I said earlier, let's move that to protected property. I should use to have access to it my get name method here, otherwise that won't work. Let's see it in action. So here we go, we have an error, 500 internal server error. Whoa, what it is. Okay, let's fix it. It says in cut error cannot access protected properties product name because the property is protected, so we need to use a getter. Get name. Here we go. That will fix the problem immediately. So we have all the titles. So the title should be in the center and the background of the other should be dark. Let's go to the other class. I'm using all utility classes to speed up development, so I don't have to write CSS for now. I will write some CSS, but just few of it. BG dark, and that should have a text of white, and be centered. Let's see. Yeah, that looks nice. And let's scroll down. We need some more padding, I think. Card there, probably we need to add a class here. That's the header. Okay. Now that's the original. Yes, okay, we have more padding to the top and to the bottom because I used the utility class card header. Okay. Now we need to add the title. Sorry, the image, because we already have title, so we remove this title and we keep this text, and we simply output the description. So we keep the image here for now. We'll use it in a minute. Let's use something inside the card body. Let's say that's lead. I'm going to use just a paragraph for that for now, and I don't need the title. That can be just the text, and let's make it bigger. And let's output here our description. So the description is public for now, so we can just output the item description like that. Remember to add the semicolon at the end. And here we have all the descriptions. Yes. Okay, now what else we need? We need this price and the button. Let's start by adding the price at the footer as a footer element. So let's add the footer inside our article, and let's call it card footer. That's a utility class from Bootstrap. And then around the XL background of dark, and then we text, we center the text, and the text should be white, so text white. And in here let's put a an em tag and say price. Let's say it's sterling, and the price itself. Let's wrap the price in a strong element so it's bold. Okay, and then we need to set the echo item price. So the price is still a public property, so we don't need to get price, but let's make them all protected. So we use our methods, since we have them, we use them. Okay, where it is, we are here. Okay, get price. And we do the same for the description. Get, the description was private before. We explained in the previous video the description. When we have a private method inside the class, so we should use another method, so get private description. Yeah, we can use it, keep it like it is, and let's see. Yes, we got the price at the bottom, we got this to the top, and now let's see what else we need to do. Let's see, we need to round these corners. I didn't round it at all because there is no such utility class rounded Excel. So let's make it. So let's add some CSS to our page head. So here, let's start by declaring our utility class. So what do we call it? Rounded Excel. Where is that? Okay, rounded Excel. And let's say that this was for the radius of 1 RAM. Okay, let's see if it works. No, that's the region. Still doesn't. Okay, the card footer has the border radius already in place, so we need to override it. Let's say that it is important. No. So we say this is takes precedence. Yes, fine. Okay. And then let's close this. We don't need for now. Okay. Now we need an image. I think it's pretty much looks similar. Yes. Probably the font should be smaller than that. Let's set a font size for the world page. So let's say HTML and body will have a font size of 14 pixels. Now, yes, okay. That should be home, not products. Let's change that inside our navigation bar. Okay. Our jumbotron says product page should say object oriented PHP. Am I wrong? No. Okay, now change this title. Okay, we are getting there. So now we need to set an image for our products. How do we do that? We should have a new method inside our class, inside our product class, a new property, and define the image in here. So we have name, description, and price. We should have also color. It can be public. Yeah, we don't care. I mean, this is just for testing purposes. So let's say color, then let's say another public property where we have the image, and that's it for now. We will add more, so we need to accept the image, and we already have the color inside our constructor. So let's say image, and let's add the image here inside our constructor. So this image is equal to our image property, and then we can scroll down. We have a set name, set description, set price. We could have other two methods, set color and set description and set image. So let's do that. Set color, which say color, and then we return the color. And let's put the dark block. Set and assign a color to the product, and then we say that we have a parameter, and that is a string, and the parameter is the color, and the description is the product color, and that returns a string. Should be the at annotation in front. We return WS at the end, and we return the color, product color. Okay, that's pretty much it. Now we can do another method. Let's grab the method and copy it. So we do it quickly. Assign an image to the product. So that's going to be image and product image. Let's copy that so we don't need to write it again. Image, image, image. And set image. Okay, that looks fine for me. The image is going to be a string because of this is what we are going to pass to our method, and that's pretty much fine. Okay, set name, set description, set price, set color, set image. Then we have the getters that we use to get properties out of our object. And then let's see what we can do to import an image. Okay, for images, what I am going to do is to use Unsplash. The service Unsplash that we can use is their API to grab an image, a random image from the users. And the option that I'm going to use is the random search term, which mainly says that we can use an image using this link and even specify sites. Then we have search query, and we can search for anything we want using the keywords. This is the syntax. So let's start by using our method. The website is source.unsplash.com, and let's see, it's here. Okay, let's see, we will place the image just below the card header. So let's do it using our set method. So we say we grab the first, let's try grab the first website. It's in the position 0, 0 because the array is 0 based, and we use the set image. Here we have our method set image, and then in here we need to pass a string. That says that we have an error, bunch of errors, because we need to say that our image, let's go back inside our product class, and since we passed to the constructor the image property parameter, we need to say that can be null, null, so we don't have to pass the image URL immediately when we create a new object. So that's going back to normal, and then now we can pass the query string, the, and let's grab this and output a random image. Let's say that we want an image which is 300 pixels by 300 pixels, and since we are talking about websites, it's a good query could be coding. Let's see, we should have now one image for the first item. Let's go back inside our view, and in here we should get the image. Since the image is public, we can simply grab the image property. So let's replace that. Class is fine. Pretty much. Let's say okay in here. I open the PHP tag and say that we want the item image. And the alternative text should be the title of the product. Let's keep it like that. Let's keep this class for now as it is, and let's see if we should see the image for one of our products. Instead we don't. We should see one. Might not have saved. We should have one. Let's far dump the entire website array and see what we got. So every time something doesn't look right, we can use the var dump and output to the screen. Yeah, we have the source and splash 300 coding. We have the image. Yes, I know what it is. We didn't echo out the image. Indeed, we didn't. Okay, we need to echo out. We could use the short form syntax to echo that out. And yes, we have the first image. The short version of the syntax that does not require you to echo out the code is the one. And you see we still have the image using this one, but I will keep it simple and use the echo instead. Okay, now let's add some more images to our array of websites, and then one, I'm grabbing every element of the array in this way, and then I use the set image method that we defined inside our product class and pass to it a string where we have stored our image URL. Now what I could do is to change a bit our products our product images by using a random here. So we've got random images, and let's change that. And then I will change the query. Okay, and instead of everything to be called query, we say web, and then we could say computer. Then we could say M using random names and images. And then I can say Android and PC. Let's see if we got a nice set of images now. Yes, that's, we couldn't find one. Which is the third one? Couldn't find an image. Computer. Okay, we should have six images now. Yes, now we go web, computer, mountain. Well, that doesn't look very right, but I mean it's fine. Android, we should get a phone probably. Yes, okay, that sounds fine. Okay, that's a frog. Why a frog? Okay, that's fine. I mean, we don't care what kind of images we are receiving from this query, because it's just an example that what we could do. In the real world, we will have a form just for administrator of the website that can use to add products images to the its sites and upload more websites, more products. But for now, what I'm doing actually is simply using an array of products. Could be even an API call to another service where we fetch some products. For now, that's fine as it is. Okay, let's grab now more. Let's grab more products for this section here, where we have some bicycle objects. We use the bicycle subclass, but I am going to refactor that a little bit, because I don't want to repeat myself over and over and write the same code again for the card. So what I'm going to do is collapse this column. I will cut the column, and I will create a new file inside our view, a new folder, and I'm going to call it partials. And inside here I will put a new file, and I will say that this is the product card.php, and I will place inside here the HTML code. And now inside our index.view.php file, I can simply say include, can remove that either, I can say include, and then the name of the file. Since we are already in the view folder, I am only going to say partials / productcard.php, and that should be fine, and that should do the trick. Yes, we still have all our images and products, and I'm still putting these lines we don't need. Let's remove that. Where was that? Yeah, let's remove the var dump. Okay, now I can use this one again inside this inside the loop, and let's grab the entire products element and copy it inside the the bicycle tab, and let's rename to bicycles. and let's say this is a bicycle variable array, and let's look through the bicycles. We don't have yet the bicycle array with bicycle products, but we will have it in a minute. So that's going to be a new array with products and images. Let's copy that and let's place it here. But instead of calling this website, I'm going to call it bicycles. And instead of creating a new product object, I am going to create a new bicycle object using this bicycle subclass. And what we got is pretty much the same, but the bicycle has more properties. And we should pass to it a frame size and the wheel size and the color after the price. So let's say the first bicycle is, let's first call it bicycle. Let's give it a name. First bicycle. Really creative. Assigning names. Okay. First. And let's do the same for all the other bicycles. Let me copy that. Do that. First. Second bicycle. We need more parameters, as I said. So let's give it a color. Let's say red as a string. It's red, and then we need the frame size, which is an integer, can be 21 point anything. And then a wheel size, let's say 28. I'm putting random numbers here, we don't care. Now again another color. Could omit the color, I think. Let's go back to the bicycle object and then we assign to the bicycle object to the constructor the color. Well, we could avoid using it. I would put inside the color and assign to the color the default value like we did for the product class. So let's say all the particles are black, so I don't have to put color every time, but the point constructor has one. Should be fine like that. Now let's say that we have only these two. Yes, and that's fine. So I don't have to put colors. So third bike, fourth bike, fifth, and the sixth. Okay, now that can stay the same, we don't care for now. Okay, now let's assign to each of these bicycle objects a new image. Let's replace the website with the bicycle variable name, and let's say instead of coding we have what? Bicycle vehicles. And let's query also color. Let's see if we got different results every time. So we don't have all the same images in here. Let's say this is red, this is white. I'm just assigning random colors so we see different images every time. Gray, and let's say green. Okay, we have images for the particle objects, and we have the particle objects, and let's see what we got now. Page isn't working. We made a mistake. Tag name undefined somewhere. That's JS. Let's see. Class particle PHP line 19. Line 19, I bet it is the constructor. Let's remove that, because we inherit that from the parent class. We should pass it. And here as well. And now we should see we have an error because we didn't choose colors for every image. Let's give it colors. Yes. Every particle has a color, so pass to it some random colors. We should have been able to ignore this value. We'll check that later, because we passed to it a default value inside our prod class, so that should be fine. But you know, okay, we have the products, and we should have bicycles not moving through the pills, so we should have accidentally deleted something here inside the pill. Change that to parallax and that's just products, and that's just bicycles. Let's remove the pills word in front of that, because I didn't call them pills, just product tabs. Bicycle tabs, that should do it. Still not. Sounds like our HTML is broken. Let's see where to fix it. That's probably the idea that we don't want. Fine. And now scroll down and let's see the tab pane, tab content. That's wrong as well. That's wrong. That's wrong as well. Now that should do it. Oh Jesus. Oh, that's wrong. Something else is wrong inside our code. Let's try to fix it. So we have this and this, that should open. Okay, we have the products ID, and we should link the products. The href should be the products and products tab, and the data toggle is tab. The rule is tab, bio control is products, and I have selected this true for the products, and then we have false bicycles, rule tab, href is bicycles. And then we have the tab as dot toggle ID bicycles tab. Fade show active. The ID is products. Rule is tab panel one. And they are labeled by products tab. Bicycles tab is the other one. Bicycles. That should do it. I'm not sure why it's not working. Should be able to browse from one to the other. We've done it a little earlier. What's going on? Let's see on the errors. It worked earlier. That's what it is, coding. Sometimes you get stuck. It should be really a stupid mistake somewhere. That's the same for all the. Let's change to this description. We don't need that for now. Let's see. There might be a problem somewhere. I don't think it's the class because we really but since we got some errors, yeah, see, that was the class. Bloody hell. Okay, there was the class not letting us scroll through these two tabs because we set the private method and could not access the private method from the subclass. So let's make sure that our bicycle class, so we don't need this for now inside this project, so the get description can stay public, and let's remove that from our bicycle class as well, and let's see if we got other errors in the terminal. I don't think so, and indeed we don't have any error. Let's move forward. Okay, now we have our, let's remove, close the Google Inspector for now, and let's see what else we can do. Okay, now we have the products, they are not clickable, we cannot click anywhere, we don't have a footer actually. So let's add the footer, and we should add also this view product button that we'll link later on to the product itself. Let's save that. And let's collapse this little bit because we don't need it for now. Now this is our index file. So at the bottom, let's output a footer. Okay, and inside the footer, let's place some link. So this is going to be, let's give it an ID of page footer and the class of padding 5, and let's enter the text. Okay. And inside the footer we will just put a link to my website. So and an anchor tag. My href. And then let's set up target and say blank, and in here let's say rel okay, and then my name that should be fine, and let's see how it look like. So we have the header, we have the navigation bar, we have the jumbotron, we have these tabs, and we have the footer at the bottom with my link, and the loop open up my website. Okay, now what else we need to do? The button, we say that we want a button here, so let's add the button to our product card. And where should we place this button? Before the footer, inside the lead probably. Let's see. Yeah, let's place it after the lead. So let's put it inside the paragraph and let's text center. And then let's say an anchor button. I'm always using Bootstrap links. I want this one. So the color should be dark. For now, no link. The color should be dark. And we don't need an ID or name. So a simple button which doesn't go anywhere for now. We don't need to set the wall for this project, it's fine. And let's see, view product, let's see what we got. And here we go, we have the button where it should be, and the cart looks nice as they should. And we have the bicycle products. We cannot go anywhere for now, and we will make a route for these pages, and we will implement routing also for the single product. So let's first do some cleanup, and we don't like to keep the code like that because it's not going to be really easy to manage, and when we need to add more routes, so we will need to add more views. So for instance, we will need a about.view.php for the about page. Then we have another page, if I'm not wrong, we have the contact page. So contact.view.php, and this is a short introduction also to the model view controller approach in programming, where we separate the layers between the classes that are named models, the views, and the controller that we will see in a minute when I'm going to build the routes. So now we need another page that we will use later to display the single product. So let's create a single page for a single product. So inside here we create a new file, and I'm going to call it single. single.view.php, and that's going to be where we will put the HTML to show our product, which is this one. Let's go back to the main project. So when you clicked on a product, we can see the product page and the title of the product, the description, the price, and the previous and next button, and the product image. And we can go forward and backward and see different products. Also, we have this menu that is different from the one we made. Yes. And these tabs as well, we will fix them later on. Now, what I am going to do is refactor some of my code so I can easily reference it to the different pages. The first thing that I'm going to do is cut the header and put it inside its own partial. What I will cut is the part. First, let's grab the navigation and remove the navigation from here. I want to keep it separate. So I will put the navigation inside its own file, and I will call it navbar, and that's it for now, and let me include it. Since we are right inside the view folders, we only need to say partials and grab the product bar, the nav bar. Then what I want to do is cut everything from the header and up to the HTML doc declaration, doc type declaration, and place everything inside his own partial that I am going to call add. So the add.php file contains the top of our HTML page, and then let's save this, let's give it some space, and let's include our file. So we are in the view folder, so we need include, and then the partials, the add. Okay, and let me also remove the footer. So after the last tab, I am going to cut the entire footer and the rest of the HTML code and place it inside its own partial. So folder, and copy that, let's remove the space, and now we have the folder and we can include it. Partials and the folder. Okay, that should be fine for now. And what I'm going to do now is check the front page, see if everything is fine. And we don't have the navigation bar anymore, so we made some sort of mistake. Let's go back to the nav bar. And let's check in the header if there is the navigation bar. So we included that. Partials, no, that's wrong, because we're already inside the partial folder, so we only need to include the navbar.php file, because we are already in that folder, and the menu should be back. Okay, now we still cannot click any link. Let's wrap the image inside the link and then we will make it clickable. So let's go back inside our, let's close some of these files that we don't need. Let's close the footer, the header, the navbar, and let's go to the product card.php file and let's wrap the image inside an anchor tag. And then let's say that this link should be just for now an href which goes nowhere, but we will make it clickable in a minute. Now we should see nice end, yes, when we over it, that goes nowhere, but remembers us that we need to make this clickable. Now let's try to go somewhere else, and the about, that doesn't change anything, and let's start by implementing a basic route. So what I want to do, let's close the product tag and the index view file. So first in the navigation bar, let's say that this goes to the home page, this goes to the about page, and this goes to the contact page. Okay, if we click here, nothing is going to change because we have no routes. But if you look at the original project, we provide to the user a different page every time it clicks somewhere. So let's implement that. So what I would like to be able to do in here is actually, let's move this code somewhere else and keep refactoring. That is really a good product because keeps the code clean and easy to read. So let me create a new file that I'm going to call product, where we will keep all the information about the products. So like that. That is a PHP file, so we need to open in PHP tags at the top. And that's fine. And then we need to import the file. So let's require it. And it's in the main project folder inside the root of our project. And that's fine. So everything should still work, but our index entry point is much cleaner. Let's see. Yes, everything works fine. We can move between the different product pages and not click anywhere or see any other page. Let's make pages available. Let's close the product page. Now what I want to do is create a route. So I will ideally what I want to do is to say route register and then pass to it routes, an array of routes that can be saved to a variable like route list. We don't have anything like that at the moment, no methods that we can call named register, but we can make it one. So that should be an object, so that we should instantiate like that. New route. Okay, but we don't have any route object, so we can create one, and inside here we will pass an array of routes, so something like that, an array. So when we visit the home page, which is empty, we will already react to a controller, which is the place where we write the code of what is going to happen when the user clicks on the link, and where we should redirect the what we should serve. So let's say that's going to be like controllers / index controller dot php. Let's create this file. Should be a comma here. And we should put a semicolon here. So let's create in the main project folder a file called route, and then let's first create all the routes that we want. So when you visit the about, I want to use the controllers dot about dot php, and when you visit the contact page, I want to use the contact controller. Okay, now we should create a route class, because we instantiate an object and place inside the route class the register method. So let's create that. Let's first open the PHP tags and let's declare what this file does using the tag blocks. So this is the route. This is the route controller. Route class, and the author is me. And the license is fine. Is this year and the name of the copyright? The copyright that should be known as the year and the name of the holder of the copyright. That's fine. And then let's create our class. So let's say class and route. Let's remove all that we don't need. And what should we place inside here is a variable that is the routes array, and it's an empty array for now. And then we should put a register method. And that receives the array, and inside here we just return this routes equal routes property. So what we are doing is register a protected property with all the routes as an array. So we register an empty array with routes name, and then inside the class we create a method that we named register that receives a parameter which is our routes array, and then we simply return it. And then let's put some doc block and describe what we are doing. So these are the route class variables, and that's a var with the string. That's actually not true. That's actually an array, and says routes. The okay, and then inside here we should put another dot block and say that this is the register method. Application routes. So this is the method that we use to register the routes for our application. that receives a parameter, which is an array, and its name is routes, and the application is this description, and then that returns the array with our routes, and that should do the trick for now. So when we hit this endpoint, we call the controllers.index.php file that should serve this view actually. So let's create our first controller. So inside our index file, we created the routes array, and we instantiated a new route object, and then we pass the we save the register method results, so the registered routes, to the routes list that we will use later. When we want to actually to serve the single views for the products. Alright, now let's create a new folder inside our root, and let's call it controllers, and inside here we can create different controllers. So first file is the index controller.php file, and then we have other three files. Let's create them. So we can create the about, and then we can create the contact, and then we can create another controller that will be the one that we will use to serve a single page for our products. And that's pretty much it. And let's see what we should put inside our first controller. So here in our index.php file, the entry point, we are returning this file with the view that we want to show for the application, but we want to show a different view for each one of these routes, and this file should be returned from its controller. So when we visit the home page, we should hit the controller, and then in here, that's a PHP file, we should include the view. So that's views. Let's say that we want to require this view. Let's see if that works for the rest of the routes. So inside our about page, we do pretty much the same. So we show to the about controller, using the about controller, we serve the about.view file, and then from the contact controller we do the same. Let me copy that. We do the same, and we serve the contact.view.php file. So that's basic routing that should do the trick that we need. And let's see what we got. Let's first check our views. They should be empty. So let's see the about view. Yeah, that's empty. Let's put just an H1 about page. And let's do the same for the contact page. Okay, now we should be able to see our code. So we have the registered the routes. We could refactor this inside its own file. I'll do it later. And let's see if that works. We got 500 error. Must have made some mistake. So okay, didn't find the class route because we did not import the class here. I'm going to import the class at the top. Let's say require .php file. That should do fine now. That's empty. Empty response. And we have another error. No. So it is not working because controllers index dot controller dot php. Let's see the controller. Most of the time it can be a typo. Okay, we hit this URL and then we hit the controller. When we hit the controller, we should return the, yeah, we don't have to require, yeah, we should require the view. So is that name correct? Views index.view.php, and that should be our main index file. That should work, definitely. There is some sort of error somewhere that I'm going to find now. Let's close some stuff. So let's check the route. So we have the route class and the protected routes, which is set to an empty array. Then we register the routes and we return them. That's fine. Okay, we can close the file. We don't need it anymore. Now the route, we instantiate in your route. Object, and then we register our routes. Let's fire them to the page, the route object. somewhere. Okay. The array is empty for the rows. For example, routes, we have an array with three elements. The first element is the controllers index.controller.php file. Correct. So where it is the error, where is it? So with the controller seems that our controller is doing nothing. But we have made the request, so we did not provide the right page to the controller. Let's start by renaming this capital letter to focus the instance controllers controllers that should do what we need. So we have the route. Let's move that to a zone file for now to clean up. And here, let's create another file where we save the routes. So we have a single place where we keep them, and we instantiate the route object, and then we save the route object to the route list. And we should import that